Hello students, today we are going to start with a new poem, that is The Rock and the Bubble by Louisa May Alcott. Now here this poem is a conversation between the rock and the bubble, wherein the poetess wants to tell us that the rock, being so mighty and strong, is very humble and polite and very respectful when it's having a conversation or speaking to others, whereas the bubble, being so tiny or small, is very boastful and proud of itself. And you will find that it always, though used to in this conversation, you will find, though when they are having a conversation, it knew that the rock is very mighty and strong, but it never respected the rock and used abusive or insulting, you can say, language for the rock. Whereas the rock always spoke respectfully to the bubble. So here the poetess wants to tell us that because of this boastfulness or pride, the bubble had to face a bad end at the end of the poem. Let's see the poem. A bare brown rock stood up in the sea. The waves at its feet danced merrily. Here you can say a description of the atmosphere is given near the sea here, that in the sea a bare brown rock which is standing in the sea, and the waves, when it came near the, you can say, rock, when it came near its feet, they used to dance merrily. A bright little bubble came sailing by, and with those waves, one day what happened? A bright means a very shiny little bubble. It came sailing near the rock, and thus to the rock did it gaily cry. Means it is very, you can say, bright, shining bubble, and it was very happy when it was. It came sailing with the waves here, and when it came near the rock, it said very gaily, means very happily or pleasantly. It said to the rock that, please move, see here. O barren brown stone. Means now here you will come to know that as it was very shiny and very delicate bubble, so it spoke very rudely to the rock, and it bubble told to the rock that you are very bare, you don't have any color, you are not at all beautiful. So it said, it referred to the bubble, you can say, rock as, O bare brown stone. From this particular sentence or line we come to know that the you can say bubble was very proud of itself. What did it say? Make way from me. Means it is telling to the rock that, get out of my way, I want to go with the waves. I am the fairest thing in all the sea. See how it is boastful of itself. It is saying that I am the fairest thing in all the sea. Means I am the most beautiful thing in all the sea. See my rainbow robe. Means with this, you can say, small bubbles, where it gets evaporated into the cloud and the rainbows are formed and all. So it makes a beautiful rainbow. So it is saying, see my rainbow robe and the crown of light. Means see the light which is there in me. As we have come to know starting of the poem only, it has been mentioned, it was very bright little bubble. See my glittering form. Means see, it is saying, see how glittering I am, so airy and bright. So means I have air in it, and I am so bright in color. The rainbow robe, the colors are seen in my, you can say, bubble here. And I am wearing the crown of light, there is shine in me. So it is being very boastful of its beauty. Here you can say, over the waters blue, I am floating away. Means, and I am floating over the waters. Means sea water is of blue color. To dance by the shore with the foam and spray. Means why I am floating here? I am floating to dance by the shore. Means to dance near the shore. With the foam. Foam means what? Mass of small bubbles. And spray. Then let me pass, for the waves are strong. Means it is saying, just allow, move away from my way and let me pass, because the waves are very strong. And their rippling feet bear me fast along. Rippling means what? Flowing in an irregular current with a bubbling noise. Means the waves, they come very fast here. So here the bubble is saying that the for the waves are strong and their rippling feet bear me fast along. They will come and take me with a great speed here near the shore. But the great rock stood in the midst of the sea. But it is saying, but you are standing in middle here, so I cannot go here. You are standing in middle of the sea and looking down, said pleasantly. As I told you, the rock was very strong and mighty one, so it had to look down when it had to speak with the bubble here. But still, the rock was not very proud of itself. Very pleasantly, very politely, with a pleasing face, what happened? It just looked down at the bubble. See how politely it said here, little friend, you must go some other way. I have not moved this many a day. Means what it is trying to make bubble understand, that it is saying very politely that little friend, you must not try to tell me to move, because from many days or many years I'm standing here and I cannot move away. I cannot move like how you go on floating here. I cannot move here. So I am helpless. I cannot help you. You have to take other way and go from here. Billows have dashed. Means a large sea wave. Billows means what? A large sea waves. And fierce winds blow. But my sturdy form, it is not overthrown. Means here it is trying to make bubble understand that large sea waves have dashed me, fierce winds have dashed me, but I am sturdy form. Means my form is naturally made by God, is very strong and solid. I cannot move like you, and no one can move me. Not fierce wind, means not strong wind, or not the large sea waves also. No one can move me. I am very mighty and I cannot move along. I am very strong. You have to take some other way and go. Very pleasantly, very nicely, it made bubble understand this. Nothing can steer me, means nothing can move me, not waves nor the wind. In air or sea, then how can I move, little bubble, for thee? Means it is saying here, the wind which is there in the air, it cannot also move me. The waves which are there in the sea, it cannot also move me. Then how can you how can I move for you? Then the waves all laugh and their voices sweet. Means when the other waves, when they heard the conversation between the little bubble and the mighty rock, they laughed at the bubble. And the sea birds looked from their rocky seat. Means the sea birds which were sitting on that rock there, they also heard this conversation. So they were also laughing at that tiny bubble, and the waves also were laughing at that tiny bubble. At the foolish bubble who loudly cried. Means they were laughing at the foolish bubble. They said how foolish it is. The bubble is, it cannot understand that it is such a small thing, such a tiny thing. It can take another wave away in the sea and move away. But it is trying to tell that mighty rock to move. So still it very loudly it is telling to the rock. See what it is saying here. While its round cheek glowed with angry pride. Means when the bubble was having conversation with the mighty rock, it was the cheek of that bubble had become very, you can say, red with pride and anger here, you can say. You shall move for me and you shall not mock. And what I say, you rough old rock. See how you can say very harshly it is speaking to the rock here. It is saying here, the bubble is saying, you have to move for me. Don't give me any silly reason. And you shall not mock. Means you should not try to tell me that you are very mighty and you cannot move and I am very tiny, so I should take another way and go. So don't tell me that. And I am telling you, you rough old rock. Means it is trying to insult the rock by saying that you are very rough and old. You are not at all beautiful. Just move away from my way. Be still, rude birds. Why stare you so? Stop laughing, waves, and let me go. Means it is telling to the birds that keep quiet. Be still, rude birds. Means it is the bubble is very angry with the birds and the waves because they are laughing at it. So it is saying that be still means be quiet, woodbirds. Why are you staring? Why are you looking at us? Why are you paying attention at a conversation? And waves, you also stop laughing and allow me to go. For I am the queen of the ocean here. See how it is being boastful about itself. The bubble is saying why she wants to go and why she wants rock to move for it. So it is saying that I am the queen of the ocean here and this unkind stone cannot make me fear. And it is saying that I am being with the beautiful one in the sea here. So I am the queen. So this unkind stone has to make way for me and move away from here. It cannot fear me. It cannot scare me. That it cannot move and I am being tiny, so I have to move here. And dashing rudely up, what a scornful word. Means scornful means what? Expressing extreme contempt. Means here you can say insulting words for the rock here. Be saying all these things that you are very bare, rough, old rock and all. It said with a scornful word, it just dashed very rudely to the rock and the foolish bubble broke. Because of pride and all, it did not realize that how mighty and strong that rock is. And when it dashes the rock, what happened? The bubble broke out. Means it vanished here into the water here. But the mighty rock, it never stayed, means it never moved because it is very strong. So dashing of the bubble wind cannot harm him or cannot have any effect on him. So then the seabirds whispered, sitting in their nest, to the downy little ones lying near their breast. Means what happened? When the seabirds, they saw all this conversation and how the bubble broke because of its pride into the sea and the mighty rock, it's still standing there. They have learned a lesson. So these sea birds, they are whispering to the down little ones who are there in their nest. Be not like the bubble, headstrong and vain, seeking by violence your object to gain. Means what are they trying to tell their little ones? That don't see what you saw now, that because of its pride and boastfulness, the bubble vanished into the sea. It broke into the sea, but the mighty rock didn't have any effect on it. So here there is lesson for you all to learn. The birds are telling to their little ones that you should not be headstrong and vain. You should not be very boastful and proud of yourself. See, and you should not try to gain things for your convenience through violence and all. But be like the rock, steadfast and strong, yet cheerful and friendly. Means it is saying, try to be like the rock. It knew how powerful it is, how mighty it is, how strong it is. But still, it was not proud of itself. Very cheerfully and friendly, it spoke to the little bubble. It knew there is no comparison between the mighty rock and little bubble. But still, the rock spoke very respectfully to the bubble. So here they want to tell their little ones that you should, although how strong and mighty or how clever you are, but you should always be very humble and polite with everyone who all are around you, and firm against the wrong. Means it is not that being humble and polite, it means that you will not fight for justice or you will not speak for the wrong. It is not like that. Being very humble and polite cheerful here, you should always speak for the wrong. Means you have to try very nicely, politely, you have to try to make the person understand that the person is wrong and they need to correct themselves. So mind little birdlings, means the young ones of the seabirds, and wiser you may be, means learn from this, learn a lesson from this conversation or learn a lesson from this incident. Then only you can become wise in your future. For the lessons of the bubble and the rock in the sea, means learn from this incident which has taken place between the rock and the bubble. Learn a lesson and try to learn something good from this. They want their young ones to understand that you should never be proud of yourself, you should never be boastful of yourself, and you should not, though if you are very strong and intelligent or clever and all, but still you should be very humble and polite with everyone. But that doesn't mean that you do not speak for the wrong. You should always speak against the wrong here, and you should always try to make person understand if they are wrong here, but into very simple and polite language, not to be violent with anyone. I hope you have understood the poem. Thank you.